thanks for watching. I'm out here at my little mini range, and we got a pretty nice little pistol. This is a Taurus model 66, an older pistol. I don't think it's ever been shot. In excellent condition. I mean, beautiful little pistol. It's got fully adjustable windage and elevation, back sights. It's got the little orange insert in the front. I really like that. Helps these old eyes get on target a little bit faster. It's got a 6-inch barrel. And guys, single or double action. You can either cock it and shoot it, or you can pull that trigger. Now let me tell you guys, that trigger pull on this is sweet. And it has the target trigger, the big wide trigger and hammer. I mean, a nice, nice, super nice pistol. And this is a 6-shot. And I still think they make the Model 66 today. I'm not for sure. This one is the high gloss. I hope you can see that. Stainless, high polished, you know. So pretty nice looking pistol. Now, we're going to put some rounds through this and see how this little pistol does. Chambered in a 357 Magnum and busting some jugs maybe here in a minute. Well, I could watch those jugs explode. And 357 does a pretty good job with that. So guys, we're going to load up. We got some different ammo here. We got some Federal 38, 158 grain. We got some 357 UMCs, and they're like a lead nose, copper jacketed lead nose. So 357, and these are the UMCs, and we've got some Winchesters, and they're all these, these are 357 Winchesters, and all these are 158 grain. So we're gonna load up and put some rounds through this little pistol and see if we can hit anything with it. Now, it'll be the first time we've shot it, and probably might have to adjust the sight. And I'm hoping it's pretty much on, but we're gonna see here just in a second. So let's load up with a UMC 158 grain, and we'll just give those a try and see how they do out of this little pistol. And we might go to some 38s and see how they do. But, all right, let's give, we got a little bit bigger target there. Let's try the Silhouette one round, just to let me see where it's shooting at and give us an idea. Okay, that was a hair bit low. Pretty much where I was aiming. I was aiming on a little spot on there, but now it's down about that far. So it is shooting a little bit low. Let's try a little bit smaller target and see if I can adjust my point of aim and hit it. We're gonna try for one of the little rotation targets here. And guys, we just grazed the corner of that. Let me try that one more time. There we go. All right, now we got a paint can there. I don't think there's any paint in it, but let's see if we can hit that. There was some pain in that. All right, now we got a water bottle over to the left, and let's see if we can hit that. Oh, no problem. All right, let's see if we can hit the watermelon. And guys, I don't know if you can see it, but it blowed out a place there. Right, it just barely grazed the bottom of that. So the sights actually needs raised up on that. And I think it would be putting them right in there. All right, let's see if we got one more. And that was it. All right, let's try some 38 specials in here and just see if it does any different with those. And let's try some of the Federal 38 Special. I think these are just lead nose rounds and 38 Special. And we'll put six of those in there. Give them a try. And sometimes a little lighter load sometimes shoots a little different or a little better. And I'm going to try one at that silhouette in a 38. Now, I'm going to go for about center ways of that silhouette. There's actually a little spot there, and I'm going to try to hit that. Okay, now, I don't know if you noticed that, if you can see that, the 357, this was just a little bit low from where I was aiming, so it's actually doing a little bit better. All right, let's try for that watermelon again. All right, still shooting a little low. Let's see if I can bring it up. There we go, that's in the center of that now. All right, let's try the paint can lid down there. And we got it. We rode it. Let's see if we can pass it. And, guys, it is shooting slightly low. But not bad. We're going to load back up with some and try some of these right here. It's the PMC. And this is the 66 grain tubular. And we're gonna try a few of them. The PNC Ultra Mags. Now, guys, these are a wild looking ammo. And, but we're gonna give them a few tries. And those are plus P's. I'm gonna put six of those in there. These usually do some pretty good damage when they hit. I don't even think you can get these anymore. All right. Now I'm going to try out that paint can with these. And this, it's laying down there. And we grazed it a couple times, but let me see if I can hit that. Let's try for this water bottle here. No problem. Let's try for a little bit smaller target. There we go. How about the old pen? Right in the center of that one. All right, let's try one of the... I'm going to try at the head of that silhouette. And we actually got down, I was aiming right at the top of the head of that, and it come down just a little bit. I think that's it. Let's try one more shot. And that's it. So, guys, I mean, it's the first time I've shot it. And, like I say, I don't think it had been shot until I shot it just now, but it's doing a great job. Beautiful pistol, great trigger pull, and I think with a little bit of practice and a little bit of adjustments to those sights, and it would be doing great, because it's fully adjustable windage and elevation, and I think it would do great with a little bit of adjustment, and maybe it seems to be shooting pretty much dead on left to right, just a little low. So, guys, I wanted to bring this to you while I was out here. I wanted to try this one out and just see how it done. And so, guys, I always appreciate you watching. I thank you for all your views and comments. And subscribe to our channel so you don't miss anything. And give us a big thumbs up. It seems to help. And if you have one of these, leave us a comment down there. We'd like to hear from you and tell us what you think about yours, where it would be. Now, they make this in a blued model, and they made it in the stainless. So let me know what you have, and if you've got one, and how yours does, and how you like it. And we'd love to hear from you. So guys, we'll see you all the next time out here at the range, having some fun on the walk with Al. We appreciate you all very much. Thank you. Down here. Dirt.